Susan.
And I'm Alan.
It's good to be here today with you all. We've been talking about compassion this summer, and we've talked about having compassion for other people. And today we're going to talk about having compassion for ourselves. And compassion, we've talked about how it means you see someone's hurt and you feel that hurt and you want to help them. When we're talking about compassion for ourselves, you know you're hurting already, but it's okay to go ahead and help yourself. Help yourself feel better and take care of yourself. This is something that God wants us to do. Right before I came down and started making this video with Alan, I was reading from my Kindle, my book. And that's something I really enjoy doing, and it makes me happy. What's something you like to do, Alan?
Well, as you know by some of the messes this kind of makes, I like to make things out of wood. So I'll take a log, kind of like this. This is one I've made something out of. I found this, someone cut down a tree, and I'll turn it into a bowl. So I've made different bowls from different wood, and I like it. Makes me feel better because I'm kind of working on something, and it helps me take care of myself.
Those are beautiful, and it creates something beautiful. I have to say, my book just creates beautiful things in my mind.
Mine creates beautiful messes sometimes.
Yes, it does. It does. Well, in church, we talk a lot about loving others, but just like I said earlier, we must begin with loving ourselves. So let's start our morning with a prayer here. Dear God, thank you for your spirit within us that guides, encourages, and strengthens us. Help us see ourselves through your eyes with love, kindness, and deep joy. May we love ourselves, treasure our hearts, and celebrate our spirits. Amen. So our story today has one of Jesus' most famous commandments or laws. And we're going to read it, and you can think about what this story means. Jesus and this is from the book of Mark, chapter 12, verses 28 through 31. Jesus and the disciples spent a lot of time in Jerusalem. One day, Jesus was at the temple, which was a place where people gathered to worship God. And he was teaching and telling stories, and a lot of people were listening, but many of them had questions.
Then one temple leader was curious about Jesus. He saw that Jesus was wise and kind, and he asked, "Which one of God's laws is the most important?"
Jesus answered, "The first is, 'Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, and all your strength.'"
Before the temple leader could ask more, Jesus went on, "The second is, love your neighbor as yourself. These two are the most important of God's laws."
So, a lot of you have heard this before. We talked a lot about loving our neighbor. We talked about it in our last two Sunday school lessons. And some of you may have written a card to thank someone or done one of the quilts that Addie talked about in her art lesson. But this commandment is really interesting because it doesn't say love your neighbor more than yourself. Nope. Doesn't say that, does it, Alan?
It does not say that. It's not in there.
What's it say?
It's kind of, sometimes we forget the second part, but as yourself, meaning you should love yourself as well. And so it wants you to, of course, think about your neighbor, and we focus on that a lot, but not to forget about taking care of yourself some.
And so during this time where we've been home a lot and had a lot of time, it is really important to take care of yourself. And one thing that we did with our kids when they were little was we made paper airplanes with them. And they would have paper airplane races where they'd see how far they could get it, contests. And Alan has made some of these in Children's Chapel.
We've made a lot of paper airplanes.
That's something we do in church, at our church. We fly paper airplanes.
Yeah.
So he's going to show you today how to make a paper airplane. It's very simple, and don't get discouraged because it's fun just to throw paper around. If your airplane's not perfect, don't worry about it at all.
In fact, we would sometimes just do experimental airplanes, so you can do the one, you think about the one we're going to show you here, which happens to be the greatest airplane design that has ever been created. But beyond that, we do experimental planes.
Yeah.
And so, sometimes they'd work, and a lot of times they wouldn't. So that's
and
okay.
If they don't work, just give it a silly name, like the hammer or the bomb.
Yeah, and you make it a trick plane then.
Yeah, and they can do flips.
Yeah, so when it does funny
so
things.
That's here, cool. I'm going to move the computer so we can see what Alan's
see what
doing.
All right, so first you take it, the paper, and it's kind of like what Eddie describes as hot dog bun style or long style, and then you flip it over in half.
And this is just a regular sheet of paper, like would go in your printer or like a notebook piece of paper.
Yeah. And you try to make it as kind of, you know, right on the other piece as you can, but again, if you're a little off, that's quite okay. And then you'll just make it more of a trick plane, or it'll do just some different things. So then you open that back up, and you can kind of see it where your fold's in like that. Then fold one half onto the line that you just made in the middle. Kind of try to straighten that up there. Then you do the other one, same thing. So you kind of have a matching pair. And again, see, I'm not perfect here, and that's okay. So you have that, and you're going to fold those down in the middle like that and try to kind of get there to the corners. Yeah, so what you have, again, we just did those over there, and we just fold it over there. All right, so that's what you have. You have that now down there. Then you're going to take each corner, and you're going to fold it into here, and you're going to go onto that middle line, and you want to make, this will kind of form like a little bit of a triangle there, so because there's a next step that you'll want to see. All right, then you fold that down, and just do the other side just to match. So now you have both those folded down. Then that kind of makes a little thing here that you just bend it up and it kind of slides over those other pieces and they'll hold them in place. So you just do that right there. All right.
Put it around the other way.
Then you're going to, so now you have this all done. So now you just take it and you fold it like that. So all the folds are kind of already there, so you just fold that up like that. Now we're going to now set it kind of down this way, so you have this kind of, you know, away from you. And we're just going to bend these down to fit on the bottom of the plane. Just like that. See? Just fold that down there at the bottom of the plane. Flip it over and just give it a matching set. Like that. And you have yourself a plane. Now what you can do, and I just learned this recently. We have one kid who's an aerospace engineer and he told me something. So if you have them down, it'll go faster but be more unstable. If you tilt then the wings up so they're kind of more than halfway, it'll actually be more stable. So you can keep playing with those. If it doesn't throw real well at first, just keep either bending them up more or down more until it flies better. And that's it. There's your plane.
Wow. Thank you, Alan. Can I try that one time just to see if I can do it? So, hot dog bun.
Yep.
Hot dog bun, right?
That's right.
Hot dog bun just like this. And then,
So then open it up this way.
Open it up. Yep. So it's opened up.
And fold those down.
Then fold them down. So open up, then fold down.
Yep.
One. And then the other.
Yep. Then you're just going to bend that down.
And then we bend this down. So it's like that, and it bends down like this.
Yeah.
Cool. Kind of looks like an envelope, doesn't it?
So yep, and bend that it down. Down. And those just go down.
And then these kind of just touch the corner like that, right?
That's right.
And touch this line right here in the middle. It's kind of hard to see that line. Yeah. Should we draw a pin on it to show? Yeah. Well,
I didn't see anything.
Okay. It's just my almost 50-year-old eyes that can't see. Okay. So they're touching that line just like that. Mm-hmm. And then you flip this little part here up.
Yep.
And it captures them. Boom, they're captured. And then, what do you do, Alan?
Then you take it out. Then you're just going to fold it on those.
Oh. Okay, so then I fold it that way. Then you fold these down. Just like that. That part's not hard. I think it's a little tricky, the... There's a couple parts that are a little tricky.
Well, that's a little off there, so that's a good way to make a trick plane.
I didn't do it right.
No, you made a nice... You made it right. Made your own thing.
There. I think it'll work.
You're right, it will work. otherwise, you might fold it slightly differently like that, where it goes all the way to the bottom. But I like what you did. I think you can do an experimental one.
I can do it that way. Okay, so actually you're supposed to fold it all the way down like this. But my way was cool, too. So, you can have a lot of fun making different paper airplanes.
Then you can even draw on them.
Plymouth Rocks. I bet mine will beat Alan's. We're going to have a contest after this, and we'll tell you next Sunday whose paper airplane wins. Have fun and enjoy. There's an art project next, and then some music with Emily. And we're going to have a prayer before we go. Dear God, thank you for giving us this time together and for the fun that we can have and the joy, and help us to remember to take care of ourselves and to love ourselves just like we love other people. Not just love other people and forget about ourselves. We need to love ourselves too, because we are beautifully and wonderfully made, as you say. Amen.
Some bright morning when this life is over, I'll fly away.
Hi, my name's Addie, and today we're going to make a craft that will remind us how we can show ourselves love through taking care of ourselves. We're going to make a paper chain, such as this one, and on each link of the chain, we're going to write an example of different ways that we can take care of ourselves. This will help us show love and compassion to other people. The materials we'll need for this craft are glue or tape, whichever you prefer, scissors, whatever you want to use to color your different links, such as crayons or colored pencils, and paper. And just like the last couple of weeks, you can use either white copy paper or whatever colored paper you can find. And if you use white copy paper, you can always color it to the different colors that you want your chain links to be. The first thing we're going to do is fold our paper so that we get 4 different strips from each piece of paper we use. Now, you can decide how many links you want to add to your chain, and you can always go back and add more chains later. I'm going to do 6 today. So it's okay if your paper might have like a little bit out of the corner or something like mine does. That just happened when I tore it out of the booklet it came in. And it'll be okay because of the way we're going to tape our chain together. So how we're going to fold this is we're going to fold this hot dog style. So the long ways, and then we're going to fold it like that again so that we'll have 4 different strips of paper You want to make sure that you crease it really good so that you know what to cut. Now I like to just unfold it once, and this makes it so that you have to cut less times. And then you're going to just cut down this line that you see right here. And if it's not completely straight, that's totally okay. And you may need an adult's help, since it can be hard to cut straight. Awesome. Now we have two pieces from this side, and we just need to cut along this one crease right here, so that we have four different pieces from this one piece of paper. And if you just want to do four links to your chain, that's totally okay. So I repeated the last step with some scraps of paper that I had from previous crafts that we did together, so that I would have three different colors of paper for my chain. And if you just want to use one color or white copy paper, or do a couple like me too, that's totally up to you in how many colors you want to use for your chain. Now the next step that we need to do is think of examples that we can put on each of the links of our chain. So you just want to think of ways that you can care for yourself. And kind of examples you could think of is maybe a favorite food you like eating, or a food that makes you feel really good. It could also be a way that a game you like playing that makes you happy. Maybe being outside in nature makes you feel good. It could also be a form of exercise you enjoy doing. Maybe playing with a pet, or visiting animals, or taking care of animals. Really, whatever makes you feel good and makes you feel like you're taking care of yourself. So the example I'm going to draw right now is my favorite form of exercise, and that is riding my bike. And I really like this because I get to be out in nature and I really enjoy it. And the reason we're going to want to draw and write our examples before connecting it is that it would be really hard to try to draw on the pieces of paper after they're connected. So I'm going to get my colored pencils, looks like they're over here, my crayons. And for this step, you could just have an adult write the example of the way you want to take care of yourself. You could just draw it, or you could draw and write an example. So I'm going to write riding my bike. And I'm also going to draw a bike as a little symbol to remind me. The other examples I'll be using is spending time in nature, playing with my pets, eating my favorite food, which is pizza, and I'll also do my bike, which I'm doing right now. Oh, and brushing my teeth. I think I'm gonna draw it so that it looks like it's on the sidewalk. And you could use the same examples as me if you feel like there are things you also enjoy doing. Or you could come up with your own. Or use examples that you already do. Awesome. So I'm just going to continue that. Continue to draw on each of my strips of paper. Now that I have all of my pictures drawn for each of the links of the chain, we need to connect them. So one of the examples I forgot to say was listening to music, which I really enjoy doing. And I kind of laid out my examples in the way that I want them to be in the chain. So I kind of made the colors change each link. You can do it however you want. So what we need to do is take the first link and make a circle. So you're going to put one end, bring it over to the other end so that it forms a nice circle. And you want to make sure that you're doing this so that the example that you wrote or drew is on the outside. You don't want to accidentally make it on the inside like this. So you're just going to make a circle and then tape it. And you can actually make the circle bigger or smaller depending on where you tape it. I'm just going to make mine overlap a little bit. You can also use glue. I'm going to use tape because it's a little bit faster. But if you do use glue, just make sure that you hold the two ends together for enough time that they're not going to separate. I'm going to take my next example. And this time you're going to make a circle just like we did before, but you're going to make a circle through the other one. So you want to kind of put the piece of paper through the other circle we just made and then connect it. Now we have two links connected. Just gotta tape it again. Now we're gonna take our next one, do the exact same thing. So put it through the last circle we made, connect the ends together so that the picture is on the outside. And take my piece of tape, tape it. Here we go. So take our piece of paper, put it through the last circle we made, connect it at the ends. And tape it. I've got my last link, put it through the last circle, connect the ends, and tape. And there we go. Now we have our chain. So it's kind of fun to just like move each of the chains and read them and kind of look at them. Thanks so much for doing another craft with me. Don't forget to hang your paper chain in a place where it will remind you to show yourself love. I hope you guys have a great week. Bye!
Today I am going to teach you the final section of our song, You Are Welcome Here. So what we'll do is we'll go through the text, we'll learn the music, and then we will put it with the rest of the song that you've already learned. So we're going to check your brains and your memory and see how much of it you've remembered from the last couple of weeks. So here we go. Let's get started. This is a place of peace and grace, where all God's children have a home. This is a place of peace and grace, where all God's children have a home. God's reign will come, God's will be done, when all are loved and no one stands alone. So what that means is when God is in charge, his will, which is for all of us, to his wishes, are for all of us to be loved and for no one to be left on their own. So when he takes control, when he takes over power, we will have these things that he hopes for all of us. So this is a place of peace and grace where all God's children have a home. God's reign will come, God's will be done when all are loved and no one stands alone. And then we do our last line, all are welcome here. So let's get started with that. We're just going to do the first section. This is a place of peace and grace where all God's children have a home. God's reign will come, God's will be done, when all are loved and no one stands alone. Sounds like this. Ready, and. God's reign will come, God's will be done, when all are loved and no one stands alone. Let's do that one more time and then we'll combine them. Ready, and. God's reign will come, God's will be done, when all are loved and no one stands alone. All right, and on that last note, you will let that note crescendo. You'll let it grow into the final singing of All Are Welcome Here, okay? So, we'll practice that more with the recording. This is a place. Ready, and one. This is a place of peace and grace where all God's children have a home. God's reign will come, God's will be done when all are loved and no one stands alone. All are welcome here. And so on. Okay? So, one more time, and then we're gonna do the whole thing. This is a place. Ready, and.
This is a place of peace and grace where all God's children have a home. God's reign will come, God's will be done when all are loved and known.
So on. All right, so just as a reminder, the song starts with the question, am I welcome here? We get the response, the answer, you are welcome here. Then we have, this is a place of peace and grace. We go into that. And then at the end, all are welcome here. So that is our roadmap. All right, so we are going to use this fancy little recording I have here, and we're going to sing through this twice. Here we go. So, four measures before you come in, there is a little bit of an intro.
Sing or laugh or shout out.
How'd you do? Pretty good? How many of you guys were able to remember all of those words from the past couple of weeks? Anyone? All right, well, why don't we try that one more time? And then you will have this to practice over and over again as you like. So let's try that once again. Sing from home. Next week we will learn a new song. So I look forward to seeing you all then. Have a great week.